Welcome back, everyone, to part one of two for the war paints. Today we're going to talk about the ancestor war paints that come with the founder's package that you get automatically. It also comes with appearance settings. So right here you can see you can toggle on and off a lot of the accessories on your chief, your warrior here, and you can remove and add any mix and match any of these as you desire. The items that you have on, as far as the appearance goes, doesn't limit the amount of weapons that you can carry. So you can unequip all of the accessories and you can still carry the same amount of weapons, just in a different manner than what you see there. Now, every war paint set or combination of war paints gives you a combination of perks or a bonus for having the full set on your warrior. So let's start with the Ancestors Vermilion. Generally, this is going to be best combined with your sneak skills because it gives a 10% forest camo, 10% plains camo, and 25% map visibility range. It's pretty awesome to be able to use these when you're trying to sneak into different territories, and it's great that you can change these pretty much any time so that you can change them for your various projects. Now, I got to give props to the devs on this one, because all of these things and much of this game is built, and is the lore and the development of it is actually from real life aspects. So the vermilion is actually a bright red rock, mercury sulfide. So it's something that they could actually have found and used ground up in their everyday life. So that's what that is. That's where the red stripe comes from. So now we have our Ancestors Graphite. It gives you 6% bow accuracy, 6% pistol accuracy, and 12% damage. So this is best combined with weapons damage, knife damage. Won't affect the spear or tomahawk just because those are already one-hit kills. But this will really help you if you're trying to get that extra damage or take out those extra soldiers in a camp a lot quicker with different bows that may not hit as hard or different weapons that may not hit as hard. Again, I'm just describing the full sets here. Next up is the Shadow Bear's Charcoal. This one's pretty interesting. Best combined with all the chief gathering perks for either yourself or for your warriors, especially for the warriors. And this is probably the most important one to me early game that you could use, because it gives you 40% extra gathering with your warriors, and then 5% heal or plus 5 heal wounds, and then 9% map visibility range. So you could also use that to get that extra little distance when you're trying to set a new camp or trying to see any of the areas of the enemy's camps out there. So again, this is probably my favorite just because you have the 40% warriors gather, and I really think that's a beneficial aspect. Now last we have the Red Owl's Blood. It's kind of an interesting mix-all, but generally you can use this one for extra stamina, traveling, rolling, if you're doing a lot of knife fighting, maybe even some sneak skill benefit in here. It's great to be combined with your stamina skills. So maybe if you're using concentration a lot, this would help because it gives you that extra stamina to hold concentration longer. So it also gives you plus 5% heal wounds, 0.6 stamina a second, 0.2 health a second, 0.5 stamina a second, and 5% pistol accuracy. Kind of a catch-all there. But it's an interesting one, and it's good enough to give you some benefit and just a little bit of that boost. I would consider this the luck aspect of the war paint, so that you just have that extra bonus, that extra quick healing, extra quick stamina, to kind of give you that little bit of an edge when you're running around doing a lot of things in a camp. What I didn't get into was the war paints that you can buy from social here, and you can add those and mix and match the benefits that you see here to whatever you want to develop your chief as, and you can also mix and match with the other ones. So we'll talk more about that next time when I can get around to getting more of these bought and figured out. But I just wanted to show you all of the ones that come with the Founder's Package and the Ancestor's Bow and the Ancestor's Warpaints. And as always, thanks for stopping by.